Welcome back to the letters. I'm Jeff Grosso. This is Omar Hassan. And this is all the shit you didn't want to know about the Vans pool party. There's $13,000 in bragging rights on the fucking line. There's $35,000 for first place in bragging rights on the line. This is the biggest fucking pool contest of the year. Okay, so they want to know what you're going to see. Like, this is what you're going to see today. Like, you don't know.
Yeah. You're going to see tons of Smith grinds because that's the newest thing that every kid can do, a frontside Smith grind. Great.
Dip it. Gotta dip that shit, bro.
Mike Smith made up the Smith stop. He just went straight up the wall and Smithed over and stopped there and then fell in. He's like, Smith stop. Mike Smith rules, by the way. Then the Smith stop turned into the Smith grind. Losey kind of popularized that.
Shreddy Repus was doing Smith grinds probably before Mike Smith was probably even skating.
One of the tricks that's going to be highly abused today, and you're going to see a lot of, which I wish they would just stop already, is the backside stalefish.
Gator invented the backside stalefish. He did them for a couple contests or whatever, and then he stopped. And it should have never been done again.
And breathe, one, two.
We're here with Jeff Tatum, the inventor of the JT Air, which is now known as the backside ollie. And we're trying to get down to the history of the no-handed aerial.
I don't know if anyone ever totally invents anything in this world. You know, there's always, it's always happening in three different places at the same time and somehow comes together.
It's like a collective idea.
Kinda, yeah.
You might want to go back and talk to Olson, because, bitch, invented that, and you know, the alley-oop 50-50. That's Steve Olson, but everybody gives Schroeder the credit.
Of course, they showed it to Stacy Peralta, 78, Lakewood Halfpipe.
Ah, it's closed. The park is closed.
Do you mean this isn't the Mojave Skate Park?
No, man, this is Lakewood, Lakewood.
Tackett claims he did the ollie first in those pipes.
So does Jeff Tatum.
Yeah, so does Jeff Tatum.
I believe in Tatum, man.
You know, but you know what?
Okay, but...
But they're both full of shit, because we did it before they did in Arizona.
Before fucking Alva.
You did.
I love that.
I'm sure.
You're going to see a lot of nose grinds. You're going to see a lot of stalefishes around the corner. You're going to see a lot of frontside boneless ones around the corner.
Yeah, a lot of frontside bonelesses.
GSD did the frontside boneless on Banks. I believe it was Caballero took him to Vert. Phillips and all of his gang in Texas, boosters.
I think you're going to see a lot of hang plants and few inverts.
And not a lot of inverts.
The all-time king of the invert, Neil Blender.
A lot of people don't stall them. They do like a hand plant. There's a difference between an invert and a hand plant.
Nice inverted hand plant there.
I love hand plants. And they're a dead art form. Well, now they're back. Everybody's doing hand plants again. They're like a cool thing to do, which makes me feel good. But here's the problem. What's the problem? Oh, you all suck at it. You want to stall. The longer, the better. You should be smoking a cigarette, talking to me. Standing on the deck going, you're a fucking pussy, Grosso. Check me out. I'm the shit.
Like, if you watch that old footage of Lance Mount where he does an invert and he lands on top of the grass in that Powell video, that was an all-time clip to show you how to do an invert, because if you want to do a proper stalled invert like that, you gotta land on the deck a couple times. You know what, to tell you the truth, contests make me super nervous, so I just try to stay on or slam, and that sucks to have to do that. But if I could just have fun and try to like do my best, and if I feel like I've like skated and had a good day, then that's enough for me.
Frontside heel flip, got it!
Any place where there's a piece of concrete, a kid will test a skateboard on it. And from that, I got the idea that talking to the kids that they needed a park, and one thing led to another to the point where I decided that I knew what the kids wanted and designed it and built it, and you see here now the creation of my ideas.
You're going to see a lot of people going to board.
Yeah.
Because nobody could be bothered to do high airs anymore. Why do a high air when I can do a 2.5-3 foot high indie air and take it to board? It's so much gnarlier. If every fucking aerial you do is to disaster, it's just how you do airs. And we're here with Billy Ruff and Dave Andrick.
Hi.
The 70s and 80s greatest skateboarders, to sit here and tell you stories about the origins of the backside air. Is there even credit for the first back snare guy? Like, do you know? You're probably
right. It all started with the hippies. Hippies were the first ones to take to the air, I think, right? But
no, I want to know who that was, because there's still five people saying they were the first ones to do that.
Like, it was probably sequentially invented in several spots at the same time.
Well, you're the first guy to break fence, right? Fence high?
Yeah.
Is Andrick
Sklen? Right, yeah.
It's not a light comment to make, the Dave bio. Like, I mean, it's a fucking literally one run and the entire fucking game changed. Question mark after question mark after question mark. And sure, you can get to the bottom of some tales, you know? And aren't they better as tales? Aren't they better as folklore? Doesn't it make it all that much more magical? And that's why, you know, that's why we're bringing it up, because we were asked to.
Monty grind, man. Monty Nolder made it up. The front side one is a Smith grind, so it's a backside Smith grind, which, you know, probably pissed Monty off to no end because he named it the Monty grind.
I like this one right here, back Smith off the hip.
I want to see fucking Rune Glifberg do a fucking indie oop off the hip and fucking back Smith off the hip and move about the pool and pool skate. You know,
it's bull.
That's bull. Fuck you.
There seems to be a lot of confusion about who actually invented the lean to tail.
I think it was Alan Losey that did it first. Totally Alan Losey. He was pro before me. I was amateur and I was skating Lakewood at the time. I did it in the half pipe and it was like real big and real loud. It was like, lean to tail, Christian Soy, invents new trick. I just remember hearing the flack like, no you didn't. So you did it first, Losey. There it is there, on camera, Losey did the lean to tail first.
I don't know, there's such a changing of the guards all the time in the pros. There's so many new kids, there could be some new face that no one's even heard of showing up and winning the pro event nowadays, because it's just kids are getting so good, you know? And in the pros, it could be anyone, you know what I mean? It's not even, there's not one name, I would say, you know?
Spoken like a true professional.
Yeah, so we're here with Lonnie Hiramoto, who I thought invented the foot plant, but I'm obviously totally wrong. Here's Lonnie's trick tip. And he says right in the first opening paragraph that the first person he saw do it was Grisham.
I seen him do that and I was like, whoa, my backside is, my foot comes off all the time. I'm learning that trick.
We're here with Kyle Peralta's favorite son, first son, Mr. Steve Caballero. Did you make up the frontside slider?
I think I made it up. I mean,
you got credit for it.
Yeah, I was like probably the first one doing it in a contest. I remember doing it like right after I saw Eddie Alguera do the frontside rock.
Eddie Alguera, he's the number one man right now on the Pro Series.
All of you who think frontside rock and rolls are so wonderful, this is the guy. Fake yollies, you ever done one of those? This is the guy, he's why. Frontside inverts, this is the guy, he's why.
There was a small group of individuals that were pushing the envelope, and Schroeder was at the forefront of that.
It's just, you know, just something that was born out of necessity. Just me having no vert to skate, skating mini ramps, and so I came up with a whole bunch of new mini ramp lip tricks, and then adapted them to vert. And just by all these tricks that I had come up with on a mini ramp, you know, were not using my hands. You know, like the alley lip slides and the lip slide revert. Oh, tail slide, chafe slide, you know, without just without even ollieing to tail, just kind of whipping it to tail. It's a lot of tricks where just kind of, you know, using your feet, maneuvering, and that's what street skating does also. You know, I wasn't doing the kick flips, but still kind of a, I don't know what I'm talking about.
What do you think, Grosso? I know you'll make some claims.
I'll make total fucking claims right now. I'd like to see Pedro win it again, just because he's had a fucking rough go lately of things. He's got to get a, take his fucking foot off the fucking throttle. Like, Jesus Christ, you could win it at 10 feet instead of 15, you know? But Pedro will probably implode again. Yeah, leaving the door wide open for the rest of the boys. Tom Schar, the child with man-like head, he'll fucking, he's always a picture of composure, so he'll be in the running again. Somebody like Trey Wood, dude, you've grown up, you've gone through puberty. Change your board size.
We were talking about that fucking line of Corey Junos the other night. It's an insane combo.
Tristan Renee, Upland's Finest.
Is it Rennie or Renee? Is it Tristan Rennie, right?
Josh Rodriguez is gonna come back. Never underestimate the fucking, the vets though. Rune Glifberg, Omar Hassan, and Bucky keeps watching these fucking, these rookies make rookie mistakes and put too much heart and soul and fucking choke and implode and all this kind of crap. Eric Grisham will be entering Legends this year, so that should be exciting.
That's awesome.
Yeah, we get to watch Eric Grisham fucking do some foot plants and stall some eggplants.
Random.
The Letters is back. Season 7. And this was kind of a little teaser episode, you know? It was kind of a best of, if you will. We showed you some of the claims that we've made in the past about, you know, you got to see Schroeder, for Christ's sakes. How fucking awesome is that? You know there was a Texan in there somewhere. And hopefully it helped burn a couple of fucking minutes between heats, you know? And I hope you enjoy, you know, watching the show as much as we enjoy doing the show for you. I am not perfect. I am a fallible human being. So thanks for watching and enjoy the rest of the contest. It's the best show on earth, skateboarding. Skateboarding is the greatest freak show on earth. Click here to see more. Love Letters to Skateboarding.